Aloha, today we're gonna talk about bounties. So finally guys, finally it's coming. I've been planning this for so much time and now finally we are doing it. So bounties, I'll give you some tips and tricks regarding this so you can do it more efficient, more fast, and hopefully you'll find new things about it. Tip number one, always do it in groups. There is no reason at all to do it alone, solo. Solo bounties will take you like 20, 30, maybe 40 minutes, depending on the build. And it's so boring to run alone, like 5 acts, 5 bounties, like 25 bounties alone, just to get one round of each mats. It's not worth it. Just don't do it. There are a few ways you can do it in groups. First, you have your friends, you have a predetermined group, that's fine. You sync with Discord, you create the party, you start the bounties, that's fine. That's like most sure way to do it. If you don't have it, there is no problem. You have two more options to do it. First, like the simplest one, you just go to a public game. You go to game settings, public game, you select bounties, it's pre-selected usually. You select a difficulty, you always do want to do it on the highest one, of course. You click join, you'll be thrown straight away into a ready party to do bounties. And third one, the cons about this part is you don't know like how are the people here in the party performing. Are they fast? Are they efficient? Are they committed? Sometimes you'll get leechers that will just stay and wait for bounties. So there is a third way. This way is about using communities. So you have a lot of great communities regarding rifts. I would recommend like joining the big ones, so like Greater Refinder, Greater Rifts, and Seasons. This is a great community as well for doing bounties. So here you just join these communities and you just write in chat like looking for group or +3, +2, +1 for bounties, quick bounties. And usually you'll get the party straight away. The pros of this method is that because people are like, you are communicating with them and they are committing to the bounties, it's very improbable that you'll get a leecher first of all. And second of all, these people will be like, they will know how to do the bounties efficient. So they will be very fast. And the average party, not the fastest one, not the slowest one, will do the bounties like whole 5 acts, like in 10 to 12 minutes. Always do groups, never do solo. Moving forward. Tip number two. Once you are in the game, you have your build, everything set up, you'll want to divide the bounties. Most common and efficient way is just take everyone one act each. So it'll be 4 players, 4 acts. Usually there are the acts taken are 1 to 4, and fifth one is left for the last one because it has like some huge maps and time-consuming bounties. So just take a second like here, look what player have chosen and just try to choose an act where no one has started already. Here you see they took this act, we can take act 1, go straight to a bounty, like don't use like go to town. And then when you're done with it, you'll move to next act that is not taken or to next bounty that is not done yet. Tip number 3, be fast. Bounties is all about speed and it's all about speed of doing those bounties. So you have a lot of things to do here. Like, first of all, of course, you like to do your fastest T16 build. Be it a Chicken Witch Doctor, be it a Demon Hunter, which are really fast, be it a Whirlwind Barb, be it a Necro Mages, which I use, that uses Stuart Greaves. So you want a very fast killing and very fast walking build, mobility first. So because you'll have bounties where you'll have like huge maps, you will have to travel. And if you are slow, if you don't have any skill that increases your speed or any other mechanics, then you'll not be efficient enough and you will drag the group down as well. So fastest builds. Also, when you do bounties, focus on the bounty. Don't take shrines, don't take chests, don't click on chests, don't take everything like loot-wise from the ground, just take the essential ones like crafting mats, gems, legendaries. Because otherwise, if you take everything like yellows, blues, you'll have to travel, you'll get your inventory full, and this is bad, will come later. Why? It's more implication in a full inventory, but also you'll have to travel to town just to unload your inventory. Every travel to town takes you seconds, and in long run, these seconds pile up and you'll waste minutes, and in the longest run even, you'll waste hours, and you waste your time, you waste your group time, so be responsible, please. Next tip, make sure you go with an empty inventory or as much, like, as empty as you could into the bounties. The reason for this is, if you have a full inventory for some reason, like you come from another game or something like that, once your inventory is full, you will have, like, first of all, you'll have, when you find something new, you'll have to go to town, which I mentioned, you waste time. But the most important thing is that if someone completes an act and take the cash, the bounty cash bag, and you are running, like, another bounty, in another act with a full inventory, when they click, your bounty will just drop on the ground. And if you are like running away through the mobs and stuff, most often you will not even notice it. So you will end up the bounty cycle and you'll find out that you just missed a bounty cache, and it sucks. No one wants to be in this situation. Also, you might be in a boss location when the bounty drops and you are just teleporting to town, you lose your portal, then like you don't notice it, you go to other location, your portal, reuse your portal, it's reset, and then there is no way you can go back to that boss location. So be very careful about it, and always make sure you have space at least for 5 bounty caches, but it's better just to have like half of inventory at least empty. So always have empty space for bounties. Once you're doing a bounty, once you're about to complete an act, like before doing your fifth bounty, let's just say you completed like 4 of them, and usually boss fights are left for the end, like you have to do the boss fight, and just imagine that these 4 are completed. Always before do this, if you are in a public game, have a quick look at the other players, how are they doing, because like not often enough, but not rare enough as well, you'll have leechers in the game, and leecher is a player that doesn't do anything and wait for the caches for free or pretends to do something. So just make sure they are like 2 or 3 bounties done already, just estimate the time and how much would it take you to do it, and just try to filter them out. It's quite obvious usually, either they didn't do anything and stay in the town, that's the straight away a red flag. Either sometimes they did one and they are pretending doing the second, but they will just go to the location, they chill there. That's another flag. Also, like for example, we have a good example here, Act 3. Don't red flag a player that, let's say, has done just 1 or 2 bounties. Because sometimes, in Act 3 especially, if you have a catapult command here, if you have a clear battlefield stores or fortified bunker level 2, these are really long time consuming bounties. So just investigate further and don't rush to label the player as a leecher. Most often it's not about leeching, it's about very stupidly long bounties. Bounty types. This is the most important one, and I think it will help you a lot. It's very important to know the bounties type and how to do it, in which order to optimize it. Usually the bounties will be, if you gather them the whole pool of bounties, and you can split them in some categories. One category will be cursed chests, one category will be kill someone, and that will be like you have to kill someone on a map, and you'll have to kill an additional amount of monsters from 50 to 150 depending on the location. You have boss fights, and you'll have thematical bounties, which will be like a storyline one, like put the rest family of a dead girl, or go and break some eggs, or go and help necromancer X to do something, or go and help someone who screwed up and stuff like this. This is very important to know the type of a bounty, because what I'm going to tell you next will help you optimize and save a lot of time. First of all, what you want to do is look for a cursed chest bounty. Because cursed chest, there are 2 types of cursed chest. One is with a timer, the 40 seconds timer, and kill like 100 monsters before the timer expires. And other cursed chest of shrines is with waves. So you have to clear 5 waves and to claim the bounty. We are interested in the 40 seconds one. So for example, of a cursed chest, we have one here. This one is a 40 seconds timer one. So what you want to do, you want to go and trigger it, like start the event. You want to go as fast as you can there. Once you trigger the chest, you go away like in a spot where you can teleport to town and you straight away go to town. You see, we have like 30 seconds, or 38 seconds like left. And now when you are in town, in that seconds, you can do actually, you can start another bounty. Usually you have this one that is quite short, but just start any other bounty. You go and complete it. You kill the dude. Now the most important thing, teleport to town, but do not use your portal because you will reset the one you have at the cursed chest. So just use map, hit M and go to the town this way. It's very important. Otherwise you will screw up your portal. And once in town, you can see we have our portal to the chest. We go and finish the chest. The timer is over. We just need to kill these dudes, these mobs. And here we go. And we have two bounties done. And we used efficiently those 40 seconds. So always start with cursed chest. Also, besides cursed chest, with time, when you learn all the bounties, you'll know that there are other types of bounties, like help captain or someone in act 3, or here in act 3 also you'll have like forged in battle bounty, which you'll have to defend a blacksmith from monster attacks. Those ones have the same mechanics, like you have to fight them for 40 seconds. Remember, you don't have to be there for these 40 seconds. Trigger them, teleport to town, and do another bounty meanwhile. Next type we will abort is the ones where you have to kill someone. The bounty will consist of kill someone, and also kill a certain amount of mobs. Like here we have 100, it can vary from 50 to 150. In this type of bounty, very important is to not worry about this part of the monsters. Just go directly to the target first, then you do the monsters part. And why is that? Because here is not the case, but in other maps, if you hit a big map and the target is far away, very often you'll hit that target before you kill him. So just going straight away to him and not wasting time like running around and searching for mobs will save you time again. Next type, boss fights. In boss fights, the hard rule is that whenever you go to a boss fight, or someone from your party will go to a boss fight and you have to enter it, there will be a prompt window that you have to accept and then your party have to accept. So whenever you are not doing the boss fight, you are doing your bounty, and this prompt window will pop to you like asking you to join the boss fight. Never accept it unless you are done with all the bounties and there are no free bounties to take up like in the end. But during your act, never accept it. They will go by themselves and kill the boss. And also it's the same, it's the case to you. When you go to a boss fight, you'll hit accept, your party will hit decline, you'll get notified that they declined. Do you want to continue? Yes, you want to continue and go alone and kill the boss. So never join other boss fights unless everything else is done and there are no free bounties to pick up. Another type is the red portals type. So it's the Black King Legacy or Cursed Shrines or Shamans. Usually you'll have to walk in a red portal in a map location. For those ones, just be fast and try to ignore everything on the way to that portal. Don't stop to kill monsters, don't stop to trigger shrines, to take cursed chests or other chests. Just run as fast as possible into that portal and do the bounty. One exception when you want to actually trigger shrines if you have Nemesis Bracers is the maps where you have to kill like someone and kill a certain amount of mobs. So once you killed the target and you still have mobs to do, then it's fine to trigger shrines because you gather those kills faster because you'll spawn a champion pack. Another trick to be fast is that to learn the maps. And what I mean is that a lot of maps have two entries or like have multiple entries, and sometimes it's more efficient to enter the map not from the location suggested. Some of these maps include, like in Act 3 you have a keep depths, so the keep depth level 2 will have two entries from level 1 or from level 3. Another common one is in Act 4, the Gardens of Hope. So sometimes you have like here the Legacy. So sometimes this portal, like you can see here, this is a perfect example. If you use the suggested bounty entry in the map, you have to walk all the way here. I believe this is the, no, this is the key warden. Okay, but sometimes it will be the portal here and it will not be close to this entry. So in that case, it will be easier just to go to Act 3 and from here to go to Act 1. And you'll be straight away into this area. So imagine this was the red portal. Look at this. It's just one step away instead of you walking all this map here. So always keep this in mind. Often enough, you'll use this trick and you'll save a lot of time. We have another great example here where we need to kill Lashtong on Keeps level 1. So if we go directly where we are suggested to go, just look. Look how far away he is. So we would have to walk a lot of maze here, labyrinths, and kill a lot of stuff till we get there. But then, knowing this trick, we can go directly to Act 2, to level 2, walk from this entrance, and now look, he's just here. But the perfect example illustrating the efficiency of knowing the maps and the different entries is the Forged in Battle one. This is my favorite one. If you go, because here we can apply two techniques, two tips at the same time. First of all, if we will do it a normal way, like without knowing, being efficient and stuff, the map suggests us to go here. So we will observe, oh, he spawned here, but sometimes he will spawn very far away from this entrance. Usually it spawns further, but he always spawns near to the second entry. Always, if you go through the second level, you go straight to the one, he always will be down here. And then here we can apply the second technique because it's a second, 40 seconds timer event. So we can trigger it. We go straight away here. We do our portal, we teleport to town, the timer started. And we easily now go and do another bounty. Yeah, we are done. It's within those 35 seconds. We go to the town through the map. Remember, always to use the map to keep your portal. You go to your portal. And here 1 second and it's done. And you finish the second one quite easy and quick. Just kill this, talk to the dude, done. So in 40 seconds, instead of, in normal way, instead of being finished with one bounty, we already have done two. And remember, you are helping your team as well being fast. Another important trick, when you are done with your act, don't take the bounty, just leave it and move straight away to the next act or next available bounty. You'll collect the caches in the end when everything is done. There are reasons for this, and that is related to the tip I gave you before with full inventory. Taking those bounties straight away sometimes may caught one of your teammates in a boss fight with a full inventory, and then there is a risk that they will lose the bounty cache. The safest way is just leave them and take them in the end. And always before exiting the game, just check your inventory that you have all 5 bounties. During the bounty runs, you might quite often run into goblins. You will kill goblins and sometimes they will spawn the vault portal. Or if you run into a rainbow goblin, they will Whimsydale portal. Don't jump in to them straight away. You want to do them after the bounties are done. So just memorize, just quickly memorize the location of it, like what map was it, what act. Keep it in mind or note it down if you have problem with memory, and continue doing your bounties. Doing them straight away will you, first of all, you are slowing down yourself, but also you are being selfish and you are slowing down your teammates. Even if you call them out and you do, all of you do this, portals, you are still, like, as a team, you are slowing down and you'll do bounties in much slower. And the thing with doing them at the end is that other players that don't want to do it, they are free to go. They will take their bounties and say no thank you, they will leave again. So you don't slow down other people's, even if you are keen to do them. So always save them for the end. You want to save like vaults, you want to save Whimsydale, and you also might want to save bandit shrines. Just don't take them straight away, share it with the team. Like, tell them in the end, guys, I have a bandit shrine. You go to the location, you ask them to TP, and you do it together. In that way, you share the loot, like you give loot to your team mates as well. Also, them being there actually increases your magic find percentage because of strength in numbers buff, and it's beneficial for you as well. You'll find you have a higher chance to drop more legendaries or primal or something like that. So these things, always do it at the end. Focus on the bounties, do the bounties first. And last, like a bonus tip, is I mentioned that you have to run your fastest build for bounties, T16 build. But sometimes you may have a secondary char, like a support char, that you need the bounties for him, for her, for that char. Or also you can run like someone like Crusader, that I don't think has a very speedy build, fast enough like to keep the pace with Demon Hunters, Barbarians, Chicken builds and stuff like that. So in that case, what you can do actually is to create a secondary char, be it for just for bounties, a very speedy build like a monk or a demon hunter, stuff like that. And you do the bounties with it, you complete the bounties, you collect the cash bags, but you don't open it, you just stack it in the chest. Then you switch back to your main char that you want the bounties for, and you open them for that. It doesn't matter which class are you doing the bounties with, the loot will correspond to the char, to the class you are opening the bounties with. So say I do my bounties with Necro, but I need the materials for a Barbarian. Even if I am a Necro and I'm an intelligence based class, I will get strength items if I open the bounties with Barbarian. So remember, it matters only what class opens the bounty. It doesn't matter what class you are doing the bounties with. And now I think we covered everything. I really hope you find some new information. I really hope that you find at least something new for you. Or even if you knew things, maybe you still like get some mini tips to improve the things you knew. So now I wish you best of luck and happy hunting. Bye.